How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today I'm going to show you guys how you can use NordVPN on your Android. Now, I know I'm on PC, but I'll show you guys clips of what NordVPN looks like over on the Android as I go through the video. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in NordVPN, you'll find links to pricing and discounts in the description down below. So feel free to take advantage of those while they last. And you also find a full review in the description that'll give you an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming and torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. Okay, so very similarly to the desktop application, NordVPN looks almost identical no matter which device you're using, really. So it's very easy to use. If you know how to use it on one device, you'll be able to use it on another device, even if it's a completely different platform. So you have over 5,100 servers in 60 countries. And you still get that map design on your Android. You can just zoom in and out and pick your server, or you can slide up the servers list and go through them yourself. Now, you have specialty servers in that list, and that includes peer-to-peer servers, onion over VPN, obfuscated servers, double VPN servers, and dedicated IP servers. They all serve different purposes. So peer-to-peer servers are special servers for torrenting or any other peer-to-peer activity. Onion over VPN servers will give you the anonymity of the Tor browser on top of the VPN encryption for even more anonymity, but at the cost of slightly decreased speeds. Obfuscated servers will help you if you're in a censorship-heavy country. Double VPN servers will route your connection through two servers rather than one for extra security and double the encryption. Dedicated IP servers will give you static IPs rather than the dynamic IPs that are ever-changing when you're using the regular servers. And if you go to the options, you'll notice you have CyberSec, which is the ad blocker, and you have the split tunneling feature. Now, unlike the PC version of the split tunneling feature, where you can choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not, on the Android's split tunneling, you'll only be able to select which applications can bypass the VPN tunnel, as opposed to the desktop version, where you can choose which applications are routed through the VPN, leaving the rest of your network untouched by the VPN tunnel. You also have the auto connect options here to select which networks your VPN will trust automatically. You also have a few protocols here. For more security, generally you can go to OpenVPN, but NordVPN themselves confirmed that NordLynx will offer just as much security. You have custom DNS for an easy way to change your DNS, and tap jacking protection, which will send you alerts if a malicious app adds a screen overlay to trick you into an unintended action, and dark web monitor, which will give you alerts if your credentials get publicly exposed online. And that is pretty much it for NordVPN on your Android. Now you know what the application is all about, what these features do. You can select a server and simply connect to it, and really is as simple as that. Of course, if you are trying to, let's say, unblock Netflix, you want to select the correct server, which, let's say, maybe you're also trying to unblock Hulu or Amazon Prime, select a US server and you're good to go. It's as simple as that. And of course, if in the unlikely event that you're not satisfied with the service, you do get a 30-day money-back guarantee no matter which plan you decide to go for. And right here, you have the live chat support who can help you with your refund, which will return back to you within 3 to 4 business days. Or if you have any other questions, you can ask them. They're super friendly, knowledgeable, and helpful. Again, you'll find links to pricing and discounts if you're interested in making use of that extra discount that I procured for you. And you'll also find a full review that'll give you more of an in-depth look into the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. That's it for this video. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.